Dear friends, today we shall study about the effect of back pressure on the nozzle. A converging diverging nozzle is shown in the figure. The pressure at the inlet of the nozzle is maintained constant throughout, and pressure at the outlet of the nozzle, that is back pressure, is varied by means of a valve at the outlet of the nozzle. The pressure along the length of the nozzle is measured by means of a surge tube, which is moved longitudinally along the length of the nozzle. Now, let us consider the variation of pressure with respect to length along the length of the nozzle. Curve 1 shows the expansion of the smooth expansion of the steam in the nozzle when the back pressure is maintained at the designed value. Then curves 2, 3, 4 indicates when the back pressure is maintained above the designed value. In this curve, it is found that the steam is expanding well below the critical pressure. Critical pressure is given by this PC is equal to 0.5774 times of P1. It is shown indicated by line C. So when the steam expands below the critical pressure ratio, the velocity of the steam will be above the velocity of sound, and supersonic velocity is reached. In curves 2, 3, 4, it is seen that the steam will expand following the correct expansion line up to some value below the back pressure in each case, and then there is a sudden shock, there is a sudden rise in pressure due to shock. This sudden rise in pressure due to shock, the shock wave occurs when a supersonic fluid strikes a high density fluid at the end of the nozzle. And the effect of this shock is that there is irreversible compression of steam in the nozzle, and the velocity of the steam reduces from sonic velocity to subsonic velocity, as shown in figure C. And after the shock, the divergent portion will act as a diffuser, and pressure of the steam is increased gradually up to the back pressure. Then now consider the curves 5 and 6. In curves 5 and 6, the steam expands isentropically up to the throat, and then there is a gradual increase in pressure up to the end of the throat to the back pressure. Here, there are no shocks are observed because the velocity is undersonic. Velocity has remained below the velocity of sound. It is undersonic. To measure the loss due to shock, we have to select two points A and B on a horizontal line AB, which cuts the curve 3 or 2. Then measuring the kinetic energy at A and B will give the loss of energy due to shock. Now, under-expanding. What is under-expanding? So, in under-expanding, when the back pressure is maintained below the desired pressure, it is called as under-expanding. Under-expanding. Then when the pressure is maintained above the critical pressure, it is over-expanding. Okay, in the under-expanding, what happens is, here the steam will expand up to the, steam expands to the desired pressure in the nozzle, and then it expands violently and irreversibly down to the back pressure on leaving the nozzle. The steam expands, leaves the nozzle and expands. Thus, the result of under-expansion is that it is a, on leaving the nozzle, we find a series of irreversible compressions through shock waves and followed by irreversible expansions until the back pressure is reached. This is the effect of under-expanding. Thus, we have now studied the effect of back pressure on the nozzle. The result of the, when the back pressure is maintained above the desired pressure, there is over-expanding. The, when the back pressure is maintained less than the desired pressure, there is a under-expanding. Result of over-expanding is shock wave, which gives rise to irreversible compression, and sonic or subsonic velocity, and a loss of pressure, and under-expanding results in violent and irreversible compression and expansion taking place outside the nozzle. Thank you. This is all about the effect of back pressure on the nozzle. Thank you.